Hey everyone, and welcome to Boston Auto Blog. Back in the fall of 2020, I said the Mazda CX-30 was the gold standard of the subcompact crossover segment, that there was not one other vehicle out there in this market that could truly compete with the CX-30 has to offer when it comes to interior quality, comfort, and refinement. However, this vehicle is not perfect. It has its flaws, like the lack of legroom for the second row. But more importantly for me was the driving dynamics, as I felt as though the naturally aspirated four-cylinder engine under the hood was just not enough, that this vehicle was begging for more power, and that I felt as though that with a more powerful engine, the driving experience would be much more engaging. Well, since then, Mazda is now giving us a turbo under the hood, giving us 250 horsepower and 320 pound-feet of torque, and wow, does it make a world of a difference. Now, the subcompact crossover segment has never really been known as being enjoyable or fun to drive, and really, they're the modern-day interpretation of econo-boxes. However, if there was one vehicle that could change all of that, it was the Mazda CX-30. So that's why I am back once again with this crossover, with the turbo under the hood, to see just how different it drives and if it should be the next vehicle in your driveway. Now, before we get in this video, I want to give a huge shout out and thank you to Prime Mazda in Norwood, Massachusetts for allowing me to do this review. Their link will be in the description below, so you can check out their extensive Mazda inventory. Also, if you are interested, I did do a full review of the CX-30 with a naturally aspirated engine, and I will leave a link to that video in the description below. And so, without wasting any further time, let's get right in this review. Journalists, consumers, and enthusiasts alike have been asking the same question for the last handful of years. Why do Americans love compact crossovers so much? And the most convenient answer would be that they're practical and spacious. But for some buyers, they're not the most affordable. The easy solution is to tell these people to purchase a subcompact crossover. And more often than not, they'd give you a disgusted look, because these vehicles don't have the best features, they're not enjoyable to drive, and there's no incentive to owning one. Mazda is on a mission to change all of that with the CX-30 Turbo, which combines everything we love with this crossover. But this time, it now has the power and comfort features you'd find in an Acura or Lexus without having to pay over $40,000. Starting off with pricing, the Mazda CX-30 Turbo Premium comes in at $33,625, making this one of the most expensive subcompact crossovers you can buy in 2021 that's not from a luxury manufacturer. However, you could argue that the CX-30 is a lifted and more versatile hatchback, with a turbo supplementing the already enjoyable driving characteristics we experienced late last year. Many consumers will be quick to point out that Mazda is entering entry-level luxury territory, where crossovers like the Audi Q3 and Volvo XC40 could be cross-shopped with the CX-30, especially at a price point around $35,000 if you offer the Premium Plus trim. And we'll dive into this discussion later in this video. It's been known for a while now that Mazda has ambitions to go upmarket, rather than competing directly against Honda and Toyota. And when staring at the design of the CX-30, you see more attention to detail compared to the Chevrolet Trailblazer or current Honda HR-V, as the front fascia is classy and upscale, yet also somewhat minimalistic with the aerodynamic body lines. Mazda's approach for a sleeker appearance matches well with the CX-30, as the chrome accents outline the gloss black grille and integrate into the headlight housings. Of course, there will be plastic cladding for the front bumper, and it's here where the LED turn signal indicators will be mounted, which pulsate rather than blink for a unique look. For the premium trim, LED headlights will come standard, providing better illumination at night or during adverse weather conditions. Moving over to the side profile, adding some color contrast to our model for this review, is 18-inch alloy wheels painted in gloss black. And due to the relatively smaller tire size for a crossover, the ride quality is going to rival more expensive luxury subcompacts. A topic of discussion for the CX-30 is the aggressive plastic cladding to help differentiate this crossover with its sibling, the Mazda 3 hatchback. For more contrast and giving the CX-30 a sportier look, will be gloss black side mirrors with turn signal indicators, to go along with blind spot detection for added safety. Then coming around to the back, the CX-30 has a rounder rear fascia compared to the typical boxy appearances we see throughout this segment, which not only gives this crossover a more athletic appeal, but when it comes to styling, has characteristics not common at this price point. As we've seen throughout the exterior, gloss black accents make their way to the final third of the CX-30, with an eye-catching rear spoiler that contrasts very well with the body color. As we saw back in 2020, you will have dual exhaust outlets, surrounded by plastic cladding for the rear bumper, just to remind us that the CX-30 is in fact a crossover rather than a hatchback. And giving this vehicle an upscale vibe, you will have LED taillights and LED turn signal indicators. Under the hood, the Mazda CX-30 Turbo is powered by a 2.5-liter turbocharged 4-cylinder engine that puts out 250 horsepower and 320 pound-feet of torque, and is paired with the 6-speed automatic transmission. Where buyers are most enthusiastic, besides the enhanced performance, is the lack of a CVT, which most Japanese rivals use in this segment. It should also be noted that Mazda is pioneering into a new era for subcompact crossovers, as we'd never look at these vehicles as being fun and enjoyable to drive, but the CX-30 changes those perceptions with an ownership experience that's very engaging. Helping Mazda gain traction among consumers with the CX-30 Turbo is that all-wheel drive will come standard, and with 8 inches of ground clearance, you have some off-road capability and can take on unplowed roads during the winter. And that's something we can't say for most competitors. For fuel economy, you can expect to receive right around 22 miles per gallon in the city and 30 miles per gallon on the highway. Stepping inside, you're greeted by heated leather seats for both the driver and passenger, with the driver's side being power adjustable with 2-position memory. However, passengers will have to manually find the ideal seating position. What you're going to notice immediately is just how welcoming and comfortable the interior really is, with soft touch padding found on the dashboard and armrests, creating one of the most plush driving environments you'll find in this price range and market. In front of you, between the analog gauges, you will have a digital display that provides basic information. But more importantly is the high resolution quality and layout that looks a bit more premium than competitors, such as Toyota and Honda. One feature we don't normally see, even for some compact crossovers, is a head-up display with traffic sign recognition, blind spot detection, and a digital speedometer, which actually makes driving more safe, as you'll be focused on the road ahead rather than the gauge cluster. Now, when it comes to the infotainment system, just like we've seen with other Mazda products, you will not have a touchscreen, and instead you will have to use a rotary dial, touchpad, and quick access buttons, a similar setup to what we saw in older BMWs and older Audis. And to be honest, it makes this vehicle seem a little more upscale, especially with this functionality. Now, I would like to see dual functionality in the future where it is a touchscreen, and then if I want to use the rotary dial and touchpad, I can. But one thing that Mazda is really focusing on is safety. So the screen is close to eye level while you're driving. You don't need to worry about focusing on the center console to find the right button. The rotary dial will help you out with that. Now, of course, with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto, that's where the rotary dial does show its limitations, and that's where I don't think it pairs up that well. However, once again, it comes back to safety. I'd rather have the ability to look at the screen while I'm driving instead of looking down at a button. I just think that when it comes to the safety aspect, that's really great. But when it comes to the user interface itself, it's very simplistic and easy to go through. It's not really in-depth, which is to be expected. Most vehicles in this segment and most brands are not going to provide an in-depth user interface or infotainment system. However, we do have the Bose sound system to really amplify the audio while you are listening to your favorite music. Since we are taking a look at the premium trim today, we will not have the extra camera angles to work with when it comes to parking. So you won't have a top view camera. You're just going to have a rear backup camera. And in my mind, I think it's totally worth paying extra for with the Premium Plus trim. Just because at around $35,000, you can now cross shop the CX-30 with a base model Audi Q3 or Volvo XC40. But also when you're looking at other subcompact crossovers that the CX-30 traditionally goes up against, I think you're receiving a lot more for the price. You're getting better value overall. And then if you are looking at getting into that entry-level luxury territory, I think the CX-30 can definitely still be there in the conversation. And personally, when it comes to technology and safety, it definitely is providing a lot of value. Then as we work our way down towards the center console, you will find the buttons and dials for your dual zone climate control, 3-level heated seats, heated steering wheel, and front and rear defrosters. And as we've seen with other Mazda products in the past, it's very clean laid out and there's no button clutter whatsoever. Then, as we get closer towards the center console, you will find a USB input for smartphone connectivity. Of course, you will have your two cup holders and a small little storage compartment made for your keys. And then the center console itself is gloss black trim with a subtle, somewhat fake carbon fiber trim that will show up in the sunlight. And even though it is difficult to clean, I do like how it makes the interior seem a bit more classy and upscale. And also, as we talked about earlier, the center console is a bit wider, so it makes the interior seem a little bigger than in reality. Now, also, you will find your drive mode selector with sport mode and normal mode. Sport mode does make the steering input a little more tighter and throttle response a lot better. It's more reactive. And in my mind, sport mode isn't that bad in this vehicle at all, despite the fact that it is not a sports crossover. It actually pairs very well with the turbocharged four-cylinder engine. And then for the center storage compartment, you're going to find plenty of room for a smartphone, another USB input, and 12-volt outlet. And rounding out the front seating area, above will be a power moonroof to let in a lot of natural light to the interior. Now, back in the fall of 2020, we had taken an in-depth look at the CX-30 with a naturally aspirated engine. So if you are interested in seeing how much legroom you will expect to see in this vehicle, click the link in the description below. However, when it comes to where the CX-30 actually fits in, whether it's its segment or just what consumer base is going to buy this vehicle, it's really meant for an urban lifestyle. We're talking people who do not have families. So there's no way you're really going to be able to fit a car seat back here. It's going to be pretty tight. The CX-5 would definitely be the way to go. However, if you don't have passengers in the second row at all times, or maybe you're just living by yourself in the city or maybe with a significant other, the CX-30 is going to provide just enough. You're going to have the practicality when it comes to cargo space. You're going to have enough room up front when it comes to shoulder room. So I wouldn't hesitate when it comes to looking at a CX-30, because I think that if you do not have a family, you don't plan on having one anytime soon, then the CX-30 is definitely going to fit the bill, especially at this price point. Now, coming around to the back for the CX-30 premium trim, you're going to receive a power liftgate. And this right here is why so many people now are demanding a power liftgate in the subcompact crossover segment. Now, don't quote me on this, but I believe the CX-30 was one of the first vehicles to offer a power liftgate at this price point in this market. But anyway, behind the second row seats, you're going to find right around 20.2 cubic feet of rear cargo space. Now, that is not class leading by any means. It does outsize some hatchbacks of this size as well. You could fit around 2 or 3 bags of luggage if you are going on a road trip with a significant other, but this is certainly not going to be as practical as a compact crossover like a Mazda CX-5. So if you do need that extra room, upgrade to the CX-5. Then with the second row seats folded, that space right around doubles in size to 45 cubic feet. So overall, when you look at the dimensions, it's not going to be a class leader. It's not going to be the most practical vehicle. However, it's going to be suitable for urban living. So if you are living by yourself or living with a significant other in the city, this vehicle is going to fit the bill because it's small, so you can park in some tight spaces, but also going to provide that practicality more so than, say, a compact car or even a hatchback. Then beneath the floor mat, you are going to find a spare tire. So if you do encounter a flat on your journeys or travels, you can fix that and be back on the road. Then, not equipped on our mall today, but I'm pretty sure it will be provided when this vehicle is sold, you will have a rear cargo cover, which will keep all your valuable items out of sight. So of course, if you are like me and you have camera gear or anything of value, you can leave them back here and you'll have that peace of mind knowing that no one will be able to peek in and steal what you have. And once you're done, just press the button and the liftgate will close automatically. With all the features we've taken a look at for the CX-30 Turbo Premium, this once again leads us back to pricing and whether it's truly worth paying $34,000 for a Mazda rather than going with a vehicle from a luxury brand. Now, every single time we bring up pricing for the Mazda CX-30 Turbo, there's going to be one person that will say, I'd rather have an Audi Q3 or a Volvo XC40. And you want to know something? We could actually cross-shop the Mazda CX-30 with luxury brands at this price point because, yes, this is one of the most expensive subcompact crossovers you can buy right now that isn't from a luxury brand. So when you look at what you're getting, you get a nice interior that's very high quality, soft-touch padding found throughout, and in my mind, is totally worth the price over, say, a Kia Seltos, Hyundai Kona, or even a Subaru Crosstrek. But for those people who will say, I'd rather have an Audi Q3, let's take a quick look at that. So say we had a Q3 premium today, right with us with the CX-30. You're going to be paying around $34,000 for a base price. However, you're going to have the less powerful engine at around 184 horsepower and 228 pound-feet of torque. You will have to pay extra, around $2,000, for 228 horsepower and 258 pound-feet of torque. But then, when it comes to Audi, you want to have all the tech features. You want to have Audi's virtual cockpit, and that will cost you around $40,000. And in my mind, when you look at the Mazda CX-30 Turbo Premium or Premium Plus, and you're paying around $34,000, $35,000, in my mind, it is worth saving $5,000 and going with this crossover. Then if you're cross-shopping a Mazda CX-30 Turbo with, say, a Volvo XC40, price points are going to be very similar at around $34,000, $35,000, especially if you're going to upgrade with the Premium Plus for the CX-30. However, with the Volvo XC40, once again, you will have to pay extra for the better engine and also go with all-wheel drive. So now you're spending around $36,000, $37,000. Then when you're looking at comfort features, we're talking dual zone climate control, the laminated panoramic moonroof, or onboard navigation, now you're spending close to $40,000. So once again, even though there will be people who will say, I'd rather spend this money on a luxury brand, take a look at what you're gonna be paying extra for, because you know what? At around $34,000, the CX-30 is providing a heck of a lot of value. All right, so let's take the Mazda CX-30 Turbo out for a test ride to see how it performs, how it handles, and how it compares to the naturally aspirated version that we reviewed back in the fall. Also, with this model being a premium, we do have the moonroof, so now we can use the moonroof cam for this review. I know you guys love that angle. So I've had the opportunity to spend about 3 or 4 hours with the CX-30 today, and I completely forgot just how plush the interior really is. This is a nice welcoming environment that I find myself in that you just don't see in the subcompact crossover segment. So the dashboard is molded around you. It's a very nice driver-centric interior, and it's just a great place to be. Steering input is really smooth and relaxed, but also not loose like we see in most vehicles in this segment. So you definitely have more of that European styling to it that I think is really lacking in the subcompact crossover segment, and why I would say that you could cross shop this vehicle with the Volvo XC40 and Audi Q3. The leather wrapped steering wheel feels really nice in the hands. You also have some very aggressive 10 and 2 positions that really inspire confidence when you are on a winding back road and you want to get a little more frisky behind the wheel of this crossover. But it's really fun. This vehicle is actually truly enjoyable to drive in all situations. What you are going to notice though is that with the turbo, it pairs up very well with the 6-speed automatic transmission. I felt as though the 6-speed just was not good with the naturally aspirated version, and you feel a much better sense of refinement when it comes to the powertrain here. It's a lot more enjoyable to drive, it's more responsive, and to me, this is really where I feel as though the CX-30 has really improved drastically compared to the last time I filmed this vehicle. It's just more enjoyable to drive. You don't see this a lot in this segment where you actually have a true automatic, whereas most Japanese rivals will have CVTs. So this is a welcoming addition to the vehicle, and that's one of the reasons why I feel at the moment that the CX-30 is one of the best subcompact crossovers you can buy right now. We're now back to typical Massachusetts traffic at around 3 o'clock in the afternoon. So this test drive has really been at a slow pace. We're talking like 20 miles an hour, not the most enjoyable, but let's see if we can get some power here. I am gonna put it in sport mode. And it's definitely more responsive for sure. You don't need to get too deep into the throttle with sport mode. What I do like though is that throttle response does become more agile and quick, and steering input is so much more tight. Kind of reminds me of what you experience in German brands, especially the Audi Q3, BMW X1, and even the Volvo XC40 had some tight steering as well. One thing that really is great is that braking ability is pretty strong. You don't need to get too deep into the brake pedal to stop this vehicle, which inspires a lot of confidence, especially if you are in an emergency situation where you do need to stop this vehicle, or if you're in stop and go traffic, you don't need to worry about that. You don't need to really mash on the brake pedal. And some brands do have very mushy braking, but this is pretty responsive. Now, when it comes to steering input, it's really nice, very smooth, also very minimal body roll, which is really, really great, especially for a compact cross, or subcompact crossover, I should say. Now, what you are going to notice, and this is the overall theme with the CX-30, is that everything is smooth. So the steering input, smooth and direct. Braking is smooth as well. Accelerations are very linear, especially with this turbocharged engine. And when it comes to road noise, there's not a lot of it. This vehicle is very well insulated, and it just adds to the ambiance. It adds to the whole experience. And I have driven a lot of subcompact crossovers throughout the last few years, and this is miles ahead of its competition for sure. Now, when it comes to ride quality, this really changes up how we perceive the subcompact crossover segment, because you don't normally have a smooth and relaxing driving experience. There's always much more to be desired in this segment, but Mazda is offering us a driving experience that would be comparable to an Audi Q3 or BMW X1 or even a Volvo XC40. Everything is just smooth and relaxing, and this is a crossover you want to drive on longer journeys, and that's not something you would really say about the competition. So that's really where I feel like Mazda, in my mind, is one of the best vehicles or best brands in this segment. They've done an amazing job of creating an affordable crossover that is inspiring to drive, and also a crossover that you want to own. Because most subcompact crossovers, like the Honda HR-V, or even the Chevrolet Trax and Chevrolet Trailblazer, they're just not there. They just don't provide that comfort and that quality that you're looking for at this price point. And then also having that turbo under the hood, you have the power almost on demand. And to me, I think what Mazda has here is a true winner. And we're seeing that. I think they had a very successful year with the CX-30, despite the fact that 2020 was what it was. And I think consumers are really enjoying this vehicle overall. So at the end of the day, is it worth paying extra for the turbo under the hood? And I say, absolutely. And you're going to respond with, of course you're going to say that. You're a car enthusiast. You want more power under the hood of every vehicle. But I truly believe the turbo really transforms the CX-30 into being something more than just a subcompact crossover. Now, of course, you already have the interior quality, the comfort, and the refinement. You have a good amount of technology features to work with. And that's why I feel as though that the CX-30 is one of the best subcompact crossovers you can buy in 2021. Now, of course, you can make the argument that interior space just isn't there compared to other subcompact crossovers, especially for the second row. It can be a bit tight. And then even when it comes to cargo space, not the most practical. However, I do think it's more than adequate for most buyers who live in the city, especially if you don't have a family and you're not carrying cargo with you around at all times. I think the CX-30 is an ultimate city vehicle. It's not that stereotypical subcompact crossover that is boxy, dull, and boring. It's something a lot more. And if you don't want to spend $40,000 for an Audi Q3 or Volvo XC40, then going with a Mazda CX-30 Turbo at around $32,000 to $35,000 is most certainly worth it in my mind. Now, of course, you will be sacrificing a bit by going with the Premium over the Premium Plus, but I think that when you're looking at a vehicle at around $32,000, there's really not much you can ask for. The fact that you have soft touch padding found throughout, a nice leather-wrapped steering wheel, and a really engaging and fun vehicle to drive, I truly believe this is one of the best subcompact crossovers you can buy in 2021. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. Please like, comment, share, and subscribe for more. Also, make sure to follow me on Instagram at Boston Auto Blog, so you can see what I'm up to and what vehicles I'll be featuring in the future. And I will see you guys next time.